Hi, this is Chris Malcolm, Warning Coordination Meteorologist at the National Weather Service in Reno. I'm sort of our office's public information officer and work with the media and emergency management partners to prepare and respond to hazardous weather events. In this quick briefing, we'll take a look at the El Nino status and what that means for our upcoming winter. I wanted to start by looking back at this past summer. This chart shows a rainfall analysis using radar estimates and rain gauge data for the past 90 days. It was an active thunderstorm season across much of the region. The National Weather Service in Reno issued an above normal number of severe thunderstorm and flash flood warnings. Remember all those cell phone alerts that you were getting this summer? A lot of those were for flash flood warnings. It was even more active to our south. The National Weather Service in Las Vegas issued a whopping 303 flash flood warnings just this summer. The top image here shows you the latest analysis of sea surface temperatures in the Pacific Ocean. The bottom image shows how those temperatures differ from what is normal this time of year. The blue colors show temperatures that are below normal, which is typically associated with La Nina, and the reds indicate above normal, which is typically associated with El Nino. Lumped together, this phenomena is called the El Nino Southern Oscillation, or ENSO for short. ENSO has been shown to impact weather patterns, such as the jet stream and storm tracks, over North America, including California and Nevada. Currently, the map is showing a mix of above and below normal spots in the tropical Pacific Ocean. This leads us to conclude that ENSO is in a neutral state, neither La Nina nor El Nino. So, what does this say about our upcoming winter? So getting a little bit more into the forecast of ENSO, this chart shows you forecasts from various computer models used to predict ENSO. Computer models are sophisticated programs that take atmospheric and oceanic data and run them through calculus-like equations to help predict the weather. In this chart, the vertical axis is showing you how far the water temperature in the tropical Pacific Ocean is from normal. The horizontal axis shows you dates in 3-month blocks. For example, DJF is December, January, and February, the core of the winter months. Each colored line represents one of those computer models. You can see there's a number of different models used to predict ENSO, each with its own strengths and weaknesses. Anything within a half a degree Celsius of normal is considered ENSO neutral. Based on the latest computer model forecasts, most of the lines stay within a half a degree Celsius of normal during the winter months, kind of in that red boxed area. This gives us an increased confidence that ENSO will remain in the neutral phase through the winter of 2013-2014. Let's take a look at what ENSO neutral conditions have produced in the past for our region. This is based on climate data back to the 1950s. These charts show the percent of past winters seeing below, near, and above normal temperatures for each of the ENSO types. The left image is for Western Nevada, and the right image is for the Sierra Nevada, including the Tahoe region. Focus on the neutral phase, the ones highlighted by the red box. Of the past ENSO neutral winters, 40% have produced below normal temperatures, 40% above normal, and 20% near normal temperatures. So, based solely on past winters, temperatures could honestly turn out to be anything. Now we're looking at the same charts, but for precipitation. Remember, this is total precipitation, rain plus melted snow. Based on past ENSO neutral winters, 45 to 50% have produced near normal precipitation in our region, 30 to 35% above normal, and 20% below normal precipitation. Taking this information into account based solely on past winters, near to above normal precipitation would be the favorite outcome for an ENSO neutral winter. However, and this is very important, just like in the stock market, past performance does not guarantee future results. Also, this analysis does not explicitly talk about snowfall, which is probably what most of you are interested in hearing about. These charts just show total precipitation, that's rain plus melted snow. We honestly have very little guidance on how ENSO impacts snowfall directly, but it is important to note that snow levels have been showing a slow rising trend over the past few decades. Now let's take a look at the most recent Climate Prediction Center forecast for the upcoming winter. This forecast takes into account historical analog years like we looked at earlier, and also uses sophisticated computer models, among other tools. The latest forecast favors above normal temperatures for the December, January, February period. However, confidence in that is only low to medium. We can still have cold spells and warm days. The forecasts are for the three-month period lumped together. On the right-hand side, this is our precipitation forecast for the December through February period. The forecast is EC, which means equal chances. This means that there is no favored outcome. Precipitation could easily be above, near, or below normal. Again, this is for the three-month period lumped together. We can still have big storms, and we can still have dry spells. The bottom line, our confidence in the precipitation forecast is on the low side, and so neutral winters typically have a larger uncertainty than normal for our long-range forecasts. So that's a wrap for this winter outlook. Even though our forecast is somewhat low confidence, I hope you found this information useful. It's probably safe to say you should be prepared for anything this coming winter weather-wise. If you live near a flood-prone area or one of the recent burn scars, definitely have a plan of action in case of flooding or a flood warning. Make sure you've got a car safety kit for winter driving, the tires are in good shape before the snow flies, that you've got alternate travel plans in case of a major winter storm, and that your snowblower or snow shovel is in good condition, unlike mine. Check back at our website and social media for updates and briefings throughout the upcoming winter, and take care.